Hi guys, this is Siley here in TechnoBase channel. As we have to discuss the models in software development, up till now we saw the software development lifecycle, that is SDLC and waterfall model. Now our today's topic of discussion is prototyping model. So in this session you will learn in details about prototyping model, in which we see what is software prototyping model, prototyping model phases, types of prototyping, best practices of prototyping, advantages and disadvantages of prototyping model. So let's begin. Prototyping model is defined as a software development model in which a prototype is built, tested and then revoked when needed until an acceptable prototype is achieved. It also creates a base to produce the final system. Software prototyping model works based in scenarios where the project's requirements are not known. It is an iterative trial and error method which takes place between the developer and the client. In this model, a prototype of the end product is first developed, tested, and refined as per customer feedback repeatedly till a final acceptable prototype is achieved, which forms the basis for developing the final product.
We are going to see the prototyping model phases. Okay, so there are these six phases which is included inside the prototyping model. So in which the first one is analysis and requirement. Requirement and analysis. Second is quick design. Third is build prototype. Fourth is user evaluation. Fifth is refining prototype. And sixth is implement and maintain. So these are the six phases which is included inside the prototyping model. Prototyping model has a six SDLC phases. What we can say that? Prototyping model has a six SDLC phases, which is of requirement analysis, quick design, build prototype, user evaluation, defining prototype and implement and maintain. Okay, so in which we are going to see the first one is requirement gathering and analysis. This is a first phase which is included inside the prototyping model. So this prototyping model starts with the requirement analysis. Means in this, whatever the requirement will get from the customer or users, that will be get analyzed in this first phase. In this phase, the requirement of the system are defined in details. Right? Whatever the requirements of the system are defined in details in this requirement gathering and analysis phase. During the process, means during this process, the user of the system, who? User of the system interviewed to know what are the expectations from the system. Means the user who is interviewed to know about what are the expectations from the system, that will be in requirement gathering and analysis. The system is partially implemented before, or we can say that during analysis phase, thereby giving the customer an opportunity to see product early in life cycle. So which is partially implemented before, or we can say that during analysis phase, to see the product early in life cycle. But to whom? user. User are going to see the product early in life cycle. Now, this process start by interviewing the customer, right? This process is start by customer interviewing. So, they are developing the one model that is incomplete, high level paper model. On the basis of customer interviewing, they are preparing one incomplete high level paper model. So we can say that here identification of product requirements is cleared in details, right? Cleared in details. What cleared in details? Identification of product. It is done through the interview some product, future users and other members of the department. Okay. So that all things are happen inside the requirement gathering and analysis. Okay. What we are going to see in this? There is the prototyping model will start with the requirement analysis. Then this ways the requirement of system are defined in details. During this process, user of the system is interviewed to know about what are their expectations from the system, and the system is partially implemented before or during analysis phase to see product early in life cycle. To whom? User. And this process start is interviewing of customers and develop the incomplete high level paper model. Okay. So we can say that here is identification of product is cleared in details. Okay. So all these are related with the requirement gathering and analysis phase. Now we are going to the second phase of this prototyping model, that is quick designing. Okay. So now we are going to see in details about the quick design phase of prototyping model. Okay. So this quick designing, we also called it as a preliminary design. This quick design, we also called it as a preliminary design. Okay. So in this stage, a simple design of the system is created. Means in this stage, first a simple design of the system is created, but this is not a complete design. Okay. So now it gives about brief idea. It gives about brief idea of the system to whom? User. Means it gives a brief idea of the system to the user. These quick type of designing help to developing what? Developing prototype. Okay. So with the help of quick designing, it develops the prototype. Okay. Means a first round of quick designing is created in this stage for the new system. Means design is created for new system. Okay. Are you getting the points? Right. First, we'll see that quick designing, we'll call it as a preliminary designing also. simple design of the system is created, but it is not a complete design in quick designing. Okay, it will gives about the brief idea of the system to who? User. With the help of this quick designing, they develop the prototype. They are creating a designing for the stage, but this is for the new system will be generated. Means we can say that once basic requirement have been discussed, a quick plan of initial prototype is made. Means basic requirements have been discussed, and on the basis of that basic requirement, a quick plan of initial prototype is made. A quick plan of initial prototype is made. Okay, this quick designing is implemented when requirements are known. When it implemented? When requirements are known. What implemented? Quick design. Quick designing is made only when the requirements are completely known to the development. Okay. It includes only important aspects. It only includes important aspects. So, which are the important aspects? Input and output format of the system. Input and output format of the system. Means it will focuses on the aspect which are visible to who? To the user, than detailed plan. So these all the things which will happen inside the quick designing. In quick designing, we called it as a preliminary design. Okay. So the another name is preliminary design. Simple design is created, but which is not a complete design. It will gives us a brief idea of the system to whom? To the user. Quick designing is developed, but with the help of quick designing they are developing the prototype. Okay, so all these are the points which help to preparing the quick designing.
I hope you understand today's topic well and hope you guys enjoyed it a lot. Don't forget to like, share and subscribe for this video. Thank you.